evening is the issue of problems and difficulty in marriage. It is normal and natural that two people who are brought up in totally different homes with totally different likes and dislikes, sometimes with entire different schools they've went to and different communities they've lived in, it is only normal and natural that they have at times differences. And these differences are not unnatural. They are something that really we should understand, we need to prepare for and keep ourselves equipped. A winner is the one who knows how to handle difference of opinion. The first rule, the golden rule, always listen. That is why it is reported that you have two ears and one mouth. We would have had two mouths and one set of ears, or should I say, it doesn't even want to come out of my mouth, to be honest with you. One ear. It's impossible to have had that. Allahu Akbar. We need to listen more than we actually speak. Alhamdulillah. And let's listen to the opinion of our own spouses, our children, our parents, our in-laws. At least lend them an ear. Listen to what they are trying to say. If they come up with something better than what you have, which is closer to what the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lies in, then definitely give up your opinion and surrender to theirs. It is not a match where people think that it is my view or I will definitely not surrender. No, they say my way or highway. We don't want to listen to that type of statement, inshallah. We want to listen to what others have to say. We want to listen to their views, and at the same time, where it is reasonable, where it is understandable, alhamdulillah, be broad-minded and at the same time be tolerant for as long as it does not earn the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant that to us. Now when there is a problem or a dispute between husband and wife, the first step the Quran speaks about in Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that it is important that the two of them open the doors of communication and communicate with one another as to what is the problem. Yesterday we spoke about the importance of communication in marriage. And I remember very clearly mentioning that it is very important to have an open relation between husband and wife. You need to be able to speak. Sometimes one of the two might be more jocular than the other. Adjust to the other, inshallah. Sometimes one of the spouses likes to joke a little bit more than the other and the other gets offended. That's not good enough. Try to understand the other. Let the doors of communication be open, inshallah. If there is a matter, a problem, you have faced a difficulty, you have an issue you'd like to address, address it as soon as possible. Don't leave it for the next day because that is detrimental. In the evening what happens? It hibernates and it grows and it multiplies. By the time the morning comes, the problem is double fold or triple fold. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So that is why it is important we speak, and we speak with respect, without using abusive words, without using vulgar language. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us understanding. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah An-Nisa, وَإِنْ إِمْرَأَةٌ خَافَتْ مِنْ بَعْلِهَا نُشُوزًا أَوْ إِعْرَاضًا فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِمَا أَنْ يُصْلِحَا بَيْنَهُمَا صُلْحًا وَالصُّلْحُ خَيْرٌ وَأُحْضِرَتِ الْأَنفُسُ الشُّحَّ وَإِن تُحْسِنُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when a woman is fearing that her husband may become evil or is being bad and so on, at the time of a dispute where you find the man is turning away from you, then it is best to arrive at a solution between the two of you. Resolve it in one way or another. There are certain details mentioned in these verses which I'm not going to go into. But the crux and the message we need to take back is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالصُّلْحُ خَيْرٌ. It is better for you to resolve your matters between the two of you. And we went through quite a bit yesterday. I told you I'm not going to repeat it, but let me say one word, inshallah, that it is very, very important that we understand one another and put ourselves in each other's shoes. Last night someone came to me after I said that and told me, my wife wears high heels. If I go into her shoes, I'll probably drop. Allahu Akbar. The reality is, that is on a lighter note. We know what is meant by this, that we need to try and look at it from their angle and see what they are trying to say. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to resolve our matters. Amen. Remember one thing, never ever discuss your marital problems with the public, because tomorrow you will solve your problem and the whole public will be talking about how you are not getting on with your spouse. They won't know that the problem is solved. A fool is the one who can discuss his own problems of the house with the general public. Sometimes even your closest friends do not need to know what is going on in your own house, because they will not know how to handle that news and information. Sometimes people are waiting for you to have a problem, and then when you tell them, they start saying, Alhamdulillah, may Allah protect us. Those are hypocrites. Those are not proper Muslims. Sometimes people are happy at your loss and they are sad at your gain. So therefore, keep your happiness and your sadness within your home, inshallah. If you'd like to share happiness with those who are genuine, alhamdulillah. But as for sadness, even those who are genuine, keep them out of the picture initially, as per the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Resolve it between the two of you directly. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us do that. Remember one thing, let's not be petty in our marriages. Some small item, a small little thing, possibly a little mistake and so on, that might have repeated itself once or twice. Don't become petty. Learn to forgive and forget. Forgiveness begins at home. We know the English saying, charity begins at home. But it does not end at home as well. You know, that just came to my mind now. Inshallah, I will get to that. But to start with, when we say charity begins at home, you'd like to smile, start smiling at home first. You'd like to be good, you'd like to forgive, start forgiving at home first. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. And don't misinterpret that saying as though it would now mean that I need to be good only in the house and the rest of the places I don't have to be good. Or I should help only within my closed circle and I should not broaden the circle. No. Then slowly but surely the circle should then become bigger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us be good to absolutely everyone, inshallah, as far as possible. Then if the matter is still not resolved, sometimes it's a bigger problem. It is something that the two of them cannot solve themselves because of some reason. Allah says in the Quran, and I've just read the verse before you, وَأُحْضِرَتِ الْأَنفُسُ الشُّحِّ. A simple translation of that is man pulls towards himself all the time. Man is very miserly when it comes towards his own things. Quite stingy, if I can use that word. Shuh is the highest level of stinginess. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. When it comes to you and someone else, you are always right and they are always wrong. That is the general nature of man. So the winner is the one who can look at the other side and learn to say, look, I'm wrong, I'm sorry, and really I won't repeat that again. So what if you have to say that once, twice, three times, so long as the problem is resolved and it's your own spouse, subhanallah, your own children, your own parents, what's wrong with that? Alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. If the problem is not resolved, we are allowed to take it further. How can we take it further? Now, say for example, if a man has a wife who doesn't listen at all, who really doesn't want to fulfill her role, who doesn't want to understand anything at all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from such women. We spoke about that yesterday where we said, it is not a competition who is more powerful in the home. That's not the competition. The competition is who can fulfill the role better than the other. Allahu Akbar. Be a good mother in the house. Be a good father in the house. Let the father not try to be the mother in the home. The decisions of what formula to feed the children, let it be the mother's, inshallah. That department, leave it for her. Let her go and try and find out. Unless obviously the husband is a pediatrician. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. And thereafter, there are other decisions you need to leave for the males. Let them be the males of the home. It is not a bout or a battle, Allahu Akbar. It is some competition with one another in order to see who fulfills their role better and not who is more dominating and more powerful. Believe me, when you fulfill your role in the correct manner, you will be able to succeed both in this world as well as in the life after death. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells the man that if you'd like, what you could do to resolve the problem is show a slight bit of disinterest. Maybe you can turn away slightly. Not so much that it will compound the problem, but you need to employ your intellect. And this is why Allah gives us options. And Allah says, look, there are three, four things that you could do. Employ that which is the most effective in your house. Sometimes if you turn away a little bit, she might turn away completely. So that shows who dominates. May Allah protect us all. But if you were, for example, maybe not to speak as much as you did, possibly not to smile, making it clear what the problem is. Not just arrive at home and suddenly you stop talking. No one knows. You know, Jibreel alayhi salam stopped coming. He doesn't come to us anymore. We are not prophets. Don't expect revelation from the heavens to drop down to tell them what is the problem. You need to speak, communicate. Say, look, this is the issue. I'm not very happy about it. And you know, we'd like to see what we can do about it. Try and resolve it. If it's not yet resolved, at least they would know why you are upset. A day is more than enough. One simple action which shows disinterest is enough for a female who has a brain, inshallah. And for a male as well who has a brain. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all understanding. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if that still does not help, you may decide to sleep on the couch. Really, sleeping on the couch is a term that we use. Yes, we understand what that means is you turn away in the bedding. You might want to face the other direction, Allahu Akbar. You might want to sleep, for example, in another set of bedding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding and never let us be from amongst those whose problems even get to that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us resolve our marital problems. For those who have problems, believe me, these auspicious nights of the month of Ramadan, they are no coincidence that we are discussing this. It is a plan from Allah, directed at every single person who is listening, subhanallah. If this message has got to you, it was created for your ears. It was not meant to miss you. مَا أَصَابَكَ لَمْ يَكُلْ لِيُخْطِئَكَ. That which got to your ears, or that which got to you in any way, was never ever meant to miss you. Allah planned it to get to your ears, or to get to you if it is sustenance. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and to guide us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses a term that a lot of the people in this world have misunderstood. He says, and this is a very, very powerful term, and I hope we understand and listen to it very carefully because we don't want any misunderstanding. وَالَّتِي تَخَافُونَ نُشُوزَهُنَّ فَعِظُوهُنَّ وَهْجُرُوهُنَّ فِي الْمَضَاجِعِ وَاضْرِبُوهُنَّ. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those whom you fear that they have now turned away or they have become unruly, they are misbehaving from your spouses, meaning from your wives, or they are evil or they have some bad characteristics in them, you should employ the most effective method to resolve the matter and the problem. You may want to, I see some are actually smiling at me, they are wondering what I'm about to say. Allahu Akbar. Those who understand the Arabic language are waiting for the translation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. You may want to address her directly to give a warning, that is one. And you may want to separate the bedding, that is two. And you may want to tap her. Allahu Akbar. The term darb, daraba, does not mean to beat. It does not mean to beat. Many Qur'ans, you open them and they will tell you to beat her. That is a wrong translation. Let me give you evidence to prove what I'm saying. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum never ever beat their wives. They used a siwak. Siwak is a small stick like a toothbrush. And they tapped a woman who didn't want to look in their direction to even listen to what the problem is, to draw her attention. That is how they interpreted this, number one. Number two is the term darb is used in tayammum. That you should do darb upon the earth. Darb does not mean to beat, it means to tap the earth. If daraba meant only to beat, then that would mean when we are doing tayammum, we would have to slap the earth until our hands go red. Allahu Akbar. So remember one thing, if daraba, when it comes to tayammum, it does not mean to beat, but it rather means just to put your hand on, then you should remember women are more delicate than the earth and the soil. Allahu Akbar. Another point of evidence to prove that physical abuse is haram in Islam is that a woman has the right to seek nullification of her marriage if she is beaten up and thoroughly abused physically. Why would she be allowed to apply for a nullification if beating was permissible? Common sense, Allahu Akbar. And this is where the kuffar, the enemies of Islam, those who have little knowledge of Islam, those who surf the net to get the knowledge of Islam, those who answer the questions that creep up whilst they are reading the translation of the Quran, themselves For them, they don't know, they don't understand, either intentionally or unintentionally. They don't realize that in the Arabic language, when one word is used, it sometimes has more than 35 different meanings. Subhana Rabbi.